Real cowboys, urban cowboys, and closet cowboys all have one thing in common. They love country music. It's just that closet cowboys don't want anyone to know it. According to Jackie Ford, country music stars were once reluctant to play Melody Fair for fear they couldn't sell tickets. But it was the closet cowboys who convinced them otherwise.
The closet country fans in the North and Northeast weren't ashamed anymore, because when they opened up their local magazine, their local newspaper, they were hearing country names. So all of a sudden they could mention it at the office, and the stars heard it too.
If you just can't wait until Melody Fair kicks off its 88th season, you can hear live country music in a handful of local watering holes.
What'll it be?
Milk. In a dirty glass.
The Golden Nugget has all the ambiance you'd expect to find at a country music bar. For 3 years in a row, they've been voted the number one country night spot by Nightlife magazine. Their clientele is positive proof that you don't have to look country to love country.
It's not people dressed like this that just come to country bars. I mean, there's, you know, a lot more to offer than just cowboys.
Sure, there's drinking and dancing, but most of all, there's music. The J.C. Thompson Band has also won a Nightlife magazine award for Best Local Country Band.
We do it as a hobby. Everyone else has another job. It's kind of, some people bowl and fish, and we play country music.
Country isn't just a sound or a look. For some,
it's a state of mind. You like it, you do it. You don't have to look like it or feel like it, but if you think it, you got it.
Tomorrow night, a rendezvous with Western New York's King of Country.
We've got some fine super country music here in WXRL.
This is Mike Randall for Eyewitness News.